So per request is asked to make something that replicates the envisioned image here from TradeStation, and trying to explain the difference between aggregating this on a bar basis versus a trade basis. And that's easiest to see when we actually delve into the charts themselves. So on a time basis, this is pretty simple to recreate, and effectively what's happening is for every bar, here we have a 1 minute of Google in the past 5 days. That code, this original image, is capturing is it's taking trade count for a given bar, and it's looking at that bar to see, is it closing up, is it closing down, and then it's assigning it, an up or down tick value based upon that. So that aggregation is simple. And we can see that we do it here simply via a simple close open comparison, right? Now, we can do that and it serves as a rough proxy. We can subsequently break it down into larger lot orders, trades rather. So here, for example, you have the delta in bars with 50 plus trades. So we can do the same. For each of these, we have or should have a trade count, which is displayed here or here if it's positive or negative. You see that displayed by the vertical histogram bars. So if we put in a filter to count all of those that are over 50 trades per bar, so in this case 50 trades per minute, then we'll get this subplot down here. So we'll see that on this bar we had 69 trades, right? You can tell from that. And so it meets our threshold, it's going to get added in to this lower one down here. So we proceed for the course of the day. Now, I'm saying the importance of realizing that this is an approximation of what's actually happening is when we view the same information on a tick basis, so an actual trade by trade basis, we're going to see some material, well, we will see differences. And to examine those differences, we can jump very quickly to take the close of Google today, trade by trade basis. And we can look at what the, well, if we're going to compare it to the 1 minute chart, the estimation process was in fact accurate, then what we should see is that the final minute of trade yields a positive delta of 268, right? So what's actually happening here, we can visualize in the tick chart, and I will have to run through and change these time frames to 1 minute so that we get the correct aggregations and the correct visualization. So now we've condensed from a 5 minute window to a 1 minute window. We see that, unsurprisingly, the last 1 minute of trade in Google is a disproportionate amount of trade space if you take the horizontal distance in comparison to what it's doing at, 2:30 in the afternoon. So if we come in on the last minute, which is 259 to 3 in the close, and we look at the true aggregated delta, which is represented by this central subplot, we see that it's actually significantly less than that, right? We see that it's 45. So if we turn this guy back on really quick, see that the P trade delta is 45. And on our other chart, we were estimating that it was 268. And where that estimation comes from, once again, is the false premise that we can sort of bulk aggregate all of the trades in a single bar based on the close of the bar and call them either upticks or downticks. When in reality, we see that we have many up and downticks throughout the course of the bar formation. So to confirm things, reconcile in terms of count at least, what we should see, let me get in a little closer here, is on this bar, we should have 156 plus 111. Okay, so it's actually one trade short. So if we take the values of P upticks, P downticks in the first subplot, we see P upticks 156, P downticks of 111. The aggregate of those is 267, right? Which is one tick shy, one trade shy of the 268 that we have here. What accounts for that? Sloppiness of thinkorswim, or perhaps an aggregation error in my code, but pretty sure the code is okay. So that's really that's the difference, and I think worth noting, because if you're going to take if you're going to make deductions based off of these charts, in terms of perhaps, I don't know, when the momentum is swinging from a positive delta to a negative delta, and you're doing it based off an estimation method, it's worth noting that, the values might be significantly off. So, for example, in this last candle, the estimation method of which gave us a uptick count of 268 was 223 ticks overestimated, because we know the true tick count is 45. Come on. Now I'm zoomed out too far, but get the idea of what's happening. Now, the limitation, of course, the reason in which things are done in this manner, in the estimation manner, is many platforms, certainly retail platforms, are going to have a limitation of how many bars, how many ticks they can plot over the course of the day. Here we see for the thinkorswim platform, the limitation on its tick charts is going to be 8,000 bars. So we'll see that if we load up a different security, take Apple for instance, we have the same number of ticks, 8,000. Let's see how far back it takes us though, right? Only to 2:55, so 5 minutes prior to close in this instance, right? So many more trades in Apple than in Google. So that will be one caveat thing to note. And if we look at, the number of securities that have that trade count or fewer, that count is going to be limited. And we can do this pretty simply by creating a scan where we sum the trades for, the approximated trading day. We have to use an intraday bar in order to accomplish that and set the upper limit to 8,000. Of course, we still end up returning values that don't qualify. Once again, welcome to thinkorswim. But for those that do, let's see. So NR, for example, showed a trade count of 7,963. If we load up NR in here, what that should mean is that we can see the entire trade day within the given max that we know that the platform can handle. So if we scroll to the leftmost of the chart, we'll have a bit prior to pre-open and takes us through the close. So those are the chief differences between replicating, or well, between what's presented here as a piece of analytics, how it's done, you know, in estimation, and what's actually happening underneath if we look at it trade by trade. Hope this helped.